And he was just speaking about his problem. He said, while I wanted to go to enter into the water, after the angel has touched, but other one goes ahead of me, I don't have anyone to help me. God has heard. I don't have anyone to help me, to take me out of my situation. And what Jesus said, he said, I'm there. And if you walk to the person, the person who does not have anyone, then he told him, carry your bed and walk. Oh, hallelujah. He's a doer. Jesus is a doer.
Yes, you
not a speaker.
Yes, you
he did it.
Alibanya.
He walked immediately.
Hapo.
Carrying his bed.
Akabeba malazi yake.
You know, he removed his bed.
Aliondoa.
He carried him.
Na akaibeba.
He carried
akabeba
his problem.
Shida zake.
And walked.
Akatembea.
It's a very big surprise.
Ni jambo la kushangaza.
And you know, first he asked him, do you want to be healed?
Unataka kuponywa?
You know,
najua.
Please, I know.
Ninajua.
I'll carry flesh. This our mind. This our body.
Hizi mili zetu.
It's hard for you to believe.
Ni vigumu sana kwetu sisi kuamini.
Say to your mind.
Ambia akili zako.
Even over. Your hard situations.
When
there is nothing.
When
there is no answer. Things will be changed. Jesus said.
Yes,
my mind, your mind asks you. How is it going to be changed? Do you have anyone who can offer you this? I don't know, Jesus said.
Care
to your soul.
Care
to your mind.
Care
to people. But they can call you crazy. But with time, now it will happen. Because on Revelation chapter 3, verse
8,
there's an open door for you to receive your answer. The door which is opened by Jesus, you enter into that by faith. I'm not going to take your time too much. Okay. I'll repeat for you. Revelation chapter 3 and verse 8. I know your works. See, I have set before you an open door and no one can shut it. For you have a little strength, have kept my word, and have not denied my name. I have set an open door before you. No one can shut it. The door you will enter and take your positions. The door you will enter and take your answer. The door you will enter and take your spiritual blessing. And Jesus said, no one can shut it. Satan can't shut it. People can't shut it. Even if you don't have money, it can't be shut. But you will enter into that by faith. You know, there is a prayer. Another prayer. The Lord has taught me You see, sometimes we just say, we just bow down, and we just pray, and we just say, God, thank you, I've prayed. But by the time we're out, still we just
pray.
One day the Lord told me, I was bowing to pray, and by tomorrow the answer to come. You know, the Lord told me first, you have to believe. Because we have not yet reached to that level of seeing things after praying. And you know, I didn't just stand up to pray first, I sat down. And I thought to my mind, believe, I'm going to pray. Whether you like it or not. I'm going to the extra level of faith. I'm going to cross the faith which it brings miracle, which is faith in miracle, which is going to make you for you to enter into a faith which it brings a miracle when you don't see believing like it's there. You know, Hebrews chapter 11, verse 1. Faith is something which you just hold when you don't have your hand. Something which you speak when you don't see anything. God wants for us to enter in that kind of faith. So today, there's an open door. We'll enter in it. Jesus said, no one can shut it. Don't be a door of singing. Don't be a door of chanting. So we are going to enter. No one can shut it. Be ready to receive your answers. Be ready to receive your answers. But from anyone else, from Jesus. Jesus is going to come today. Let me read a word.
Watch us assume the name.
Malachi. Chapter 3.
Lango Watatu.
In verse 1.
Study.
You know what? I'm happy. Because Jesus is speaking. You know, I told you, what am I supposed to say? He told me, say this to my people. Jesus said, speak this to my people. I am a miracle worker. You see, they said, he's a miracle worker. He's a miracle worker. Yeah, I forgot, you know, by the time before I just came up here. And yesterday, I left my country. It was a very big surprise. But that time, many times I was traveling during night time. But yesterday I traveled during the sunny time. It was a surprising thing. Immediately the plane was leaving the land, I was feeling like crying because of the faithfulness of God. And it went up. The cloud is down. Very much down. And I have seen the faithfulness of God. You know where you go?
When
you are in aeroplane, you get faith. You see the faithfulness of God. That can't be done by human beings' power. You see the hand of God. When you come down, you speak about God. It's a very surprising thing. When we just enter into an area of Kenya, there was a very much cloud. It was cloudy. Covered completely cloudy. It was too much light. You know, something God showed me. When a plane was flying, you see, like you see in a mirror yourself. Everything the plane was doing, the cloud was reflecting to us. Just I was near to the window. When I looked to the window, So you know, God told me, sit down.
Mungu akamwambia tazama chini.
And the little plane
na hiyo ndege ndogo
was covered
ilikuwa imefunikwa
with a very high shining light
na mwangaza mkubwa.
In the second
na jambo la pili,
you know this rainbow
kulikuwa na
the green color, the red color, I was counting it, a blue color.
Alikuwa kesama.
I said, that the white light was the glory of God.
Hiyo nyeupe ilikuwa ni utukufu.
I saw it on the cloud.
Akatizama kwa mawingu.
By reflection. Imagine it was reflecting. The cloud was reflecting.
Ilikuwa ikimwonyesha.
I saw it. Even I just forgot even to just take a picture.
I saw
a miracle I saw. The plane was covered with a shining power.
Ndege ilikuwa imefunikwa.
The covenant rainbow.
Alafu imefunikwa na hiyo.
The cloud was reflecting to me.
Ilikuwa ikimwonyesha.
You have a covenant.
Kwamba uko na ahadi.
You have a covenant.
Kwamba uko na agano.
God is faithful.
Mungu ni mwaminifu.
He does.